complex numbers. In this section, we'll be working with the complex numbers. So we'll talk about four operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Let us look at what is a complex number. Let us take a few examples. You can see the first set, 3, negative 7, 5 over 2, square root of 13, cube root of negative 8, 1 over square root of 2, all these are real numbers. But if you have a number, the square root, and you have a negative 3, square root, negative 4, you can have negative outside as well. Then you have a negative here, but then it's a fourth root. So these are all imaginary numbers. The exponent here is called rational exponent. If it is 3, 5, 7, like that, still it is a real number. But if it is even, like, for example, this is 2 here, the exponent of negative 3 is 1/2, the exponent of negative 4 is 1/2, the exponent of negative 16 is 1/4. These are all imaginary numbers. Now when you combine these two together, real and imaginary, then we can call it a complex number, like, say, negative 7 plus square root of negative 8 is a complex number. So we'll be working on some operations on complex numbers. Suppose you are having a plus ib and then minus c minus id. So if you want to simplify this, you just say a plus ib minus, distribute the negative sign, c plus id. Now this is the real part here. Keep them together. A minus c plus, you can factor out I from this term and this term, you get b plus d. So I have now a minus c, this is my real part of the complex number, and then this is my imaginary part. So this all together then is a complex number. If we have another example, say you have 3 plus 2i written as a plus ib, so my a in this case will be 3 and b will be 2. So this way you just identify your real coefficient and the imaginary coefficient in complex numbers. Let us take a few more examples. We want to add two complex numbers. So this is your real part, this imaginary part, real part, imaginary part, and we have to add this. You can open parenthesis, write 3 plus 2i plus 7 minus 5i, then take the like terms. 3 plus 7 is 10, and 2i, 5i, that will make it negative 3i. So in this case, if you compare with a plus ib type, then you say a is 10 and b is negative 3. We take more examples. The next example is 3 plus 2i, now into subtract. Open parenthesis, you get 3 plus 2i minus 7 plus 5i. Now 3 minus 7 gives you negative 4. 5i and 2i will be 7i. So in this case, a is negative 4 and b is 7. The next example, we are taking multiplication of complex numbers. You can use distribution or you can use FOIL. So FOIL will be like, you can go 2 times negative 3 will make it negative 6, and then I times this will make it positive 2i squared, and then you can go here, this is negative 3i, and then go from here to here, which is plus 4i. Now we need to remember one thing here, that by definition square root of negative 1 is I, so if you square both sides you get negative 1 is I squared. So we'll be using that here. So negative 2, because I squared is negative 1. And then here you get just I. It's negative 8 plus I. So in this case, my A is negative 8 and B will be equals 1. In this example, I am taking two terms, two complex numbers. One is a plus ib, another is a minus ib. These two terms are called conjugate to each other. So what happens when you multiply a complex number with its conjugate, you will see with the FOIL what happens. A times a will make it a squared. I, this will make it, you just say, negative I squared b squared. Then next one will be plus iba minus iba. So they're canceled out. And you know I squared is negative 1, so you get a squared plus b squared. So conjugate, when you multiply, always your result will be a real number. So we say that when you multiply a complex number with its conjugate, your answer will be a real number. And what is that real number? You just say a square plus b squared. So take another example here with some numbers. Number 5. So we have 3 plus 5i multiplied with 3 minus 5i. Clearly you see these are conjugate to each other, complex conjugate. So then my answer should be just 3 square plus 5 square. If you just remember this work here, can save your time. So 3 square is 9 and 5 square is 25, which is 34. In example 6, now we are taking one complex number, say 3 plus 4i, and we divide by another complex number I, which is also compared as 0 plus 1i. So how do you work on these and put this one as a plus ib form? So the idea is you multiply numerator denominator by I and then see what happens. When you do that, I times I will be I squared in the denominator, and then distribute this I. So you get 3i plus 4i squared. And we know I squared is negative 1. It's always true. So you get here 3i minus 4 over negative 1, because I squared is negative 1. So finally, you end up with negative 3i plus 4, or you can say 4 minus 3i. When you compare, your a is 4 and b is negative 3. And we are done in this section. In the next video, I'll be talking about other forms of complex numbers when it's coming as an exponent.